Richard Branson's private Necker Island has been struck by Maria, the second hurricane to affect the island in 2 weeks. Although the British Virgin Islands has escaped the worst of the storm, Sir Richard said that the storm had brought lots of howling rain. Donald Trump urged Theresa May to increase the pressure on North Korea, posting on Instagram, he said word from the bunker is that all are safe on Necker. Lots of howling rain, 2 feet, but all okay. The night of a thousand buckets, yet to hear the latest on the rest of the BVI, thoughts are with our friends in Puerto Rico and all in Hurricane Maria's path. In an accompanying video, the billionaire businessman said all of us just need to rally together to campaign on getting on top of climate change on a global basis, so that events like this do not become recurring incidents. To view this video, please enable JavaScript and consider upgrading to a web browser that supports HTML5 video. The British Virgin Islands have been spared the worst from Hurricane Maria, the governor has said, as the storm continues her path of destruction towards another UK overseas territory. Claiming the lives of at least 9 people so far, Maria has barreled across the Caribbean and unleashed devastation on islands in its path. 15 dead, 20 missing in Dominica after Hurricane Maria, country's PM confirms, ravaging both Dominica and Puerto Rico. A hurricane warning is currently in place for the Turks and Caicos Islands, with winds of 110 miles per hour and up to 16 inches of rain expected. The U.S. National Hurricane Center warned that, although the storm was no longer a Category 5, some strengthening could take place and Maria could regain major hurricane statuses. Gus Jaspert, governor of the British Virgin Islands, which was wrecked by Hurricane Irma 2 weeks ago, said initial assessments suggested fresh damage is relatively low. "We had high winds, we had a bit of flooding, and we had a bit of a storm surge that knocked out some of the roads, but that thankfully we have been spared the worst," he said. "We are very mindful that others and colleagues in the region felt its full force, and our thoughts are very much with them at the moment." Girl dies after shooting herself while reaching for candy in grandmother's purse. Mr. Jaspert said one of his first priorities on Thursday is to head to the other British Virgin Islands on a helicopter from RFA Mounts Bay to fully assess the damage there. "We prepared for the worst, it hasn't been the worst, which is good. We are back onto our recovery focus, which is our key thing," he said. He revealed that there were no deaths, but that someone who was seriously injured during the latest hurricane is due to be medevaced off Virgin Gorda on Thursday. Meanwhile, Maria was the strongest storm to hit Puerto Rico in more than 80 years, destroying homes and plunging the entire island into darkness after taking down power lines. Widespread flooding was also reported, with some streets turned into raging rivers by the deluge of rainwater. Puerto Rico's emergency management director Abner Gomez said the weather system had destroyed everything in its path. British tourist speaks out after being drugged in Zante cocktail bar. The island of Dominica, where Maria made landfall on Monday, lost nearly all of its communications as the storm knocked out phone lines in the island's broadcast service. According to reports, 70% of properties lost their roofs. Mr. Jaspert said he had sent messages of support to his colleagues in both Puerto Rico and Dominica, who he said had been fantastic in the past at helping us out. Describing the storm as it passed, the father of two said it was long and drawn out, with a bit of an impact in the middle of the night, very strong winds, lots of debris was flying around. With some flooding affecting the island of Tortola, he added the key priority really is bouncing back into our recovery mode. Islanders still reeling from Irma devastation now brace for Hurricane Maria. Mr. Jaspert said the arrival of HMS Ocean on Friday, which is carrying 60 tons of UK aid, will turbocharge their repair work and recovery efforts. With roads, schools, the airport, the police headquarters, homes and many other buildings damaged as a result of Irma, he said there was a lot of work to be carried out. "We have got huge ambitions and we want to genuinely get this place back, quickly. Not just to where it was, but to a place that is even better than before," Mr. Jaspert said. "The long term is this is going to be a really fantastic functioning market economy. It needs some short-term aid and support, and we are getting that in now. But actually we want to bounce back and become an example of how you rebuild after a disaster." It is almost strong words at the moment, because there is so much devastation here, but I am excited about the long-term prospects.